bright, beautiful, blessed morning and bright, beautiful, blessed day. And to my brothers and sisters, it says we got 15:22 on here. And we put the kingdom of Yehovah first. We put the kingdom of God first. And all these things shall be added unto us. And we thank you, Yehovah, through Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. And hallelujah, Yehovah. Amen. I just was woken up. I had a dream. And I asked Yehovah if this dream came from him, because it was very disturbing. And he said yes. When I say that, it wasn't like violent or anything. The waters were, there was waves. First, the dream started out in the earth, and everyone were playing games. And then some of the people that I've known that have passed away, they weren't interacting with us, but they were sitting and they were talking amongst themselves about us. And a lot of the people on the earth were caught up in playing their games. They weren't focusing on what was going on in the world. And now's not the time to do that. And I was told to read John chapter 7. Are you ready? I'm going to read it with you and with everyone. And then I'll tell you, go ahead, tell them about the waters. And I was with a companion, the Holy Spirit, and there was waves coming in this place from all different directions, from all four corners of the earth. And all these people were swimming there, so I thought it would be fun, like a wave pool, like when I was little. And I jumped in, and then I heard the Holy Spirit say, "You're going to jump in there? It's over 50 feet, Raphael." It was already too late. I had already jumped. And then I went into the water, and I tried to swim, and I didn't realize how chaotic and how much the world was in chaos right now. And the water was just turning, and I tried to swim, but there was bodies all around me. And I just kept hitting their hands and their legs. And I was just hitting bodies everywhere. I couldn't swim. And then something grabbed me. The almighty hand of Yehovah grabbed me. And guided me through the waters. And swam me to safety. And then I was able to wake up. But it was horrible. All these bodies were everywhere. And there was hands and legs. I couldn't swim because there's so much water and waves were coming everywhere and bringing the bodies in everywhere. And if it wasn't for the Holy Spirit, I would have drowned in the chaos in this world. But the Holy Spirit led me and guided me. The Holy Spirit wants me to read this scripture to you. Okay. This light doesn't work because my batteries are out and I don't have money to get new batteries, but anyway. For Yehovah gives okmah. Okmah means wisdom in English. For Yehovah gives okmah, and out of his mouth cometh eldana, cometh the knowledge of God, and bina, insight, clear and true perception. Yehovah layeth up sound wisdom for the righteous. Yehovah is a buckler to them that walk uprightly. And Yehovah preserveth and protecteth the way of his saints. And hallelujah, Yehovah. Thank you, Yehovah. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for your okmah. Thank you for your bina. Thank you for your eldana. Thank you for being with us, Yehovah. Yehovah imaku. God is with you. Yehovah Immanuel. God is with us. Hallelujah, Yehovah. Amen. Now let's read John chapter 7. All right. And after these things, Yeshua, Jesus was walking in Galilee, for Yeshua did not desire to walk in Judea, because the Jews were lusting to kill him. Oh, they're lusting to kill me, huh? Yes, Raphael. And I started praying in tongues too. Ashintora pahakade, for Yehovah's word is in my heart like a fire shut up in my bones. I cannot hold it in. And we'll go here now, Sonny. These are the seven seals. There's that sucker. That thing is running wild. I see that one every day, but this one's really going all over the place. Anyway. Listos, bueno. Ready? Good. Let's go. After all these things, Yeshua was walking in Galilee. For HaMashiach did not desire to walk in Judea, because the Jews were lusting to kill him, to murder him. And the Jews' feast of tabernacles is not really their feast, it's Jehovah's feast, it's Jesus Christ's feast. And the Jews' feast of the tabernacles was near. Then his brother said to him, "Move away from here and go to Judea, so that your disciples will also see your works which you do. For no one does anything in secret, and himself seeks to be in public. If you do these things, reveal yourself to the world." Whoa. For his brothers did not believe in Yeshua. Then Yahushua said to them, "My time is not yet here, but your time is already ready." Oh, that's why all these people were dead. Yes, they are going to die. "The world cannot hate you, because the world hates me. The world cannot hate you because it hates me, because I witness about it that its works are evil." And now tell them the truth. "And I do witness that its works are evil, because in the..." Let's pause it just a little bit. "Because in the dream before we went in, before I jumped off into the waters from the earth, we were talking about how all the leaders are trannies here and how most of the Hollywood movie stars are trannies. And that's what we were talking about in my dream with all these people on the earth. And they were all like, yes, we're amazed too. We're all finding out the truth and that all these ones are trannies too. Remember I told you Satan and his trannies, the original trannies, Satan and his trannies. Well, it's written in the book of Adam and Eve, the lost books of the Bible, the forgotten books of the Bible. And there's a lot of gems in there. All right, let's continue reading chapter 7. But that I wanted to tell you about that too. "And the person that was swimming for me in the dream and that swam me to safety is called the Holy Spirit. In this chaotic world, if you want peace, you're going to die here unless you receive Yeshua. I'm just going to put it straight up. To make it as simple as I can for you in English, if you don't receive Yeshua, if you don't receive Jesus Christ, you're going to die here. You need to come to Yehovah. You need to repent. Cry out to Yehovah for Yeshua, and he will send his Holy Spirit to help you and lead you and guide you through this chaotic time, through these chaotic waters. It's chaotic everywhere. The waves were coming in from every direction. The people were just hitting... there was no room. I couldn't even swim because I stretched, out my arms to swim. And then I was just hitting body. And then my leg would hit a body behind me and then a body to my right, a body to my left. And then there were so many bodies. I couldn't even swim to get it. And it was just the waters were churning. And then all of a sudden this hand grabbed me and went through the water and just took me through the water to safety. And may Yehovah bless you to be safe and sound and secure from all evil at this time. Come to Yehovah and receive peace. Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, Yeshua, was lifted up as a peace offering. He's the only way that you can be at peace with God right now. And when you're doing your best to please God, he'll make even your worst enemies be at peace with you. I hope this blesses you with joy and comfort and encouragement and hope and inspiration. And I hope that the Holy Spirit is helping you and leading you and guiding you, and that Yehovah gives you Okma and Bina and Eldana, and that he is an invincible, impenetrable force field, the divine protection, that he is a buckler, a shield of protection for you against all wickedness and evil, and that he will help you and give you peace during this time of chaos. In the name of Yahushua HaMashiach Yeshua, Señor Yahashua HaMashiach Yeshua, Señor Yeshua, Señor Jesus Christ, Amen. The Lord Jesus Christ, Jesus, Yeshua, the Messiah, Jesus of Nazareth, as it's written in English in their scriptures, all right? In our scriptures. "Now then, Yahushua said to them, 'My time is not yet here.'" Okay. "The world cannot hate you, but it hates me because I witness about it, that its works are evil. You go up to this feast, I am not yet, he was talking to his brothers. You go up to this feast, I am not yet going to this feast, for my time has not yet been fulfilled. And saying these things to them, he remained in Galilee. As Yeshua HaMashiach, Yehovah's word is brilliant. Yehovah's word is the maker of heaven and earth, and it was not his time to be killed by these ones lusting to kill him and murder him. He said, I am Ahaya. I am not yet going to the feast, but he will, for he is the king. But when his brothers went up, then he also went up to the feast. Oh, when his brothers started celebrating the Feast of Tabernacles, then he went up to the feast too, because he knew that they're supposed to love him. Yes, Raphael, doesn't mean that his brothers do love him, but they're supposed to love him. But when his brothers went up, then he also went up to the feast, not openly, but as in secret. Then the Jews sought Yeshua in the feast. And his name is Yeshua, but they didn't seek Yeshua. They didn't seek salvation in the feast. So I'll just put, then the Jews sought him. They sought to kill him in the feast and said, where is he? Where is Yeshua? Not that they were seeking to gain Yeshua, that they were seeking to destroy Yeshua. All right, let me make a clarification. And there was much murmuring about him in the crowds. And the ones, there was two murmuring. And the ones that were murmuring, they're like, it's our time to do everything nice. Let's get everything nice that we can. Just say everything nice that you can. Nice is a power of darkness, in case you don't know. Those who are on Satan's list are naughty and nice. You don't want to be on Satan's list. You want to be on Yehovah's list. Yehovah's list are those who are loving, kind, peaceful, joyful, faithful, gentle, patient, and all the fruits of the Holy Spirit, all right? They have self-control. They love one another. They help one another. And they do justice and judgments. They stand up for what is right. They stand in love. And they let the Holy Spirit lead them and guide them during these times of chaos. Now, there was much murmuring about him in the crowd. Some said, he is a good one, but others said, no, but he deserves the crowd. However, no one spoke publicly about him because the fear of the Jews. But the feast being now half over, Yeshua went up to the temple and taught. And the Jews marveled, saying, how does this one know letters, not being taught? Yahushua answered them and said, my teaching is not mine, but of the one who sent me. If one desires to do his will, uel, he will know concerning the teaching, whether it is of Yehovah, or I speak for myself. The one speaking from himself seeks only glory. The one speaking from herself seeks her own glory. But the one seeking the glory of the one who sent him, this one is true, and unrighteousness is not in him. For Yehovah Zedkenu, Yehovah is our righteousness. Yeshua is our righteousness. Elohenu Zedkenu. Did not Moses give you the law, and not one of you does the law? Whoa. Did not Moses give you the law, and not one of you does the law? Why do you seek to kill me? The crowd answered and said, you have a demon who seeks to kill you. Yeshua answered and said to them, I did one work, and you all marvel. Because of this, Moses has given you circumcision, not that it is of Moses, but of the fathers. And upon a Sabbath you circumcise a man. If a man receives circumcision upon a Sabbath, so that the law of Moses is not broken, are you angry with me because I made a man entirely sound upon a Sabbath? Do not judge according to sight, but judge righteous judgment. Jesus Christ even told you, judge righteous judgment. And the other, yesterday the Holy Spirit said, did you judge the angels I sent to? I said, yes, not unrighteously. And the Holy Spirit said, good. And I passed the test here, because now the Holy Spirit confirms to me through the word, I judged righteous judgment, and that's good. Oh, what a joy it is unto the work, what a joy it is unto the just and righteous to do justice and judgments, but unto the workers of iniquity it shall be the four winds. Then some of the people from Jerusalem said, is this not the one they are seeking to murder, to kill? And behold, he speaks publicly, and they say nothing to him. Perhaps the rulers truly knew that this is indeed HaMashiach, the Messiah, but we know this one from where he is. But when HaMashiach comes, when the Christ comes, no one knows from where he is. Then teaching, Yahushua cried out in the temple, even saying, you both know me, and you know where I am. You know where I am. You know who I am. You know where I am.